Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this worship service here at Three Bridges Reformed Church on this Palm Sunday. It is wonderful to have each and every one of you here. As we have been able to do the last couple of Sundays, we encourage you to, if you're able, and if you're willing, to sign in to YouTube so that you're able to take part in the chat, greet one another, check in with one another, and be with one another. Even remotely, we can still be with one another. Two things that I want us to prepare for before we get ready for worship. The first is that we are going to be celebrating communion today. So I need you to have some communion elements ready for you and your family. So if you have some crackers or some water or some juice, some Cheez-Its and Gatorade, I think is what I said in the email, have those ready for you and your family so that we are able to participate and gather around the Lord's table together. The other thing that I want you, that I want the kids to think about, because we're going to have a time for the children to chat with me as well, is to let me know what kind of communion elements you have. Are you using crackers? Are you using Cheez-Its? Are you using Gatorade, water, Nilla wafers, chocolate milk? Whatever you're using, let me know in the chat so that we can talk about what that means and what communion means. Because for some of you, this might be the first time that you're actually able to participate in communion. It's good to have you here. God loves each and every one of us, and we are able to worship Him here today. So again, we invite you to sign in, take part in the chat, check in with everybody, and we will be able to worship here in a couple of minutes. We'll talk soon.
Thank you. Thank you.
morning, everyone, and welcome to Three Bridges Reformed Church this morning. It is a pleasure to have each and every one of you here already. There are a few announcements that I would like to put out there to you. The first of which is, in the midst of all of this, one of the things that we have been able to do, and I'm very thankful for Joe's energy and expertise, is we've been able to get a new website. New website platform up and running. We encourage you to go take a look at it. It's an opportunity to be able to plug into the different things that are going on, the live streams and whatnot, e-giving, and all different sorts of ways to be able to plug into the church and remain connected. So we encourage you to head over and take a look at that. As I mentioned last week, we do have four small groups up and running. So the Tuesday morning women's group, the Tuesday afternoon small group, Thursday morning men's group, and then Thursday afternoon small group. So if you are interested in being a part of a small group as we move, as we continue to move into April, please let me know. As we need to, we'll spin off an additional group so that we're able to remain connected as best we can. So there is that. The worship outline, if you're looking for the responsive readings and whatnot, I encourage you to click on Read More underneath the YouTube video feed, and you'll be able to follow the worship outline as we have it this morning. This is Holy Week, so as we enter into Holy Week, one of the things that we want to do is actually journey with Jesus to the cross. So we will be returning on Thursday evening at 7 p.m. for our Maundy Thursday live stream. So we encourage you to come and be a part of that worship service. And then we will be gathering on Good Friday, again at 7 p.m. with our brothers and sisters from the Shannock Reformed Church and Clover Hill Reformed Church. We're doing this all remotely, but we're looking to be able to bring our congregations together to worship on Good Friday. So Good Friday at 7 p.m. as well. And then we will gather back here together again next Sunday at 10 a.m. with worship at 10:15 for Easter. Those are the announcements that I have. Again, if the kids are finally just settling in, if you're able to push into the chat and let us know what communion elements that you have for the bread and wine, what do you have? What are you using? Let us know in the chat so that we can talk about that in a little bit. Those are the announcements that I have. Let us come before the Lord and let us worship him on this Palm Sunday. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. Amen.
That howl throughout me.
Check in with one another. Allow this peace that is of Christ to be extended to each and every one of us here today. As we do that, we encourage you and invite you to take a moment, and pause. To pause and recognize that we need to be with, God the way that God created us to be. Recognizing who He is. We do that by coming to Him in confession. Recognizing those things that we have done that leave us separated from God and from one another, and also those things that we left undone, that we felt moving in our hearts, moving in our spirits, that we didn't follow through on. Let us come before the Lord. Let us take the moments that we need. Let us join together in prayer. Let us pray. Patient God, we confess that we love a parade. We are very happy to see banners waving and hear people shouting their praises. Our hearts thrill to the excitement, but we fail to see the sadness on the face of the Savior. He comes to us as a king, and we want that royal treatment to continue. We do not and cannot believe that in a few days we will be among those who will turn our backs and run from His presence. We can be so faithless, yet you continually forgive us and call us to turn our lives around, to see the needs of others, to reach out in trust and faith, to be willing to witness to your good news of saving love. Heal our hearts and give us courage for the days ahead. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that all those who believe in Him might not perish, but instead would have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through Him. Jesus came into the world. He lived the life that He did so that we might have the opportunity to be saved. Not condemned, saved. Live in that place. Work to live in that place. Receive that gift. And allow that forgiveness to begin to seep into your life, even right now. You are forgiven. Jesus Christ came. His message was not to condemn, but to forgive, to love, to welcome in again. Welcome as brothers and sisters. Hear also the words of our Lord Jesus Christ as He said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is the first and the great commandment. The second one is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Let us thank God for all the ways that his law is at work in our lives here today. Amen. All right, now I'm going to look down and look at the bulletin and actually see that it is children's time as opposed to walking over the call to worship there, which I just totally blanked on because I'm over there and I'm singing away and I just totally got lost and I walked right into the camera. Hi everybody, for an extra moment there, that happens. All right, so for the kids, I want you to come on in, get a little bit closer to the TV. Bring your, if you've got your communion elements with you, I'd love for you to be able to have those with you so that we can talk about that and share that. Pastor Joe's on the other side of the camera here. He's looking at the chat stuff, so he'll be able to let me know some of the items that you've got. So, but first, before we get to that, I want us to be able to read a story, like we did last week. A story about why we have this thing called communion. Why do we do this? Why do we have this little piece of bread and share it around? Why do we have this little cup of juice and hand that around the sanctuary, hand that around your home here this morning? Why do we do that? We're going to share the story as to why we do that today. One night, Jesus and his friends were eating supper together. Jesus said, "One of you is planning to do something bad to me." "Who is it?" asked John. And Jesus said, "It is the one that I give the bread to." So he gave the bread to Judas. "Go on," Jesus told him. "Do what you are planning to do." Judas got up and left. Only Judas and Jesus knew what Judas' bad idea was. If you're wondering what that was, I want you to come back on Thursday. We'll watch the end, even if you don't watch it on Thursday night. Watch it on Friday morning to hear what Judas's plan was. The story continues like this. Then Jesus gave thanks, and he broke some bread, and he shared it with his friends. Next, he took a cup of juice, and he gave thanks. He shared this with his friends, too. He said this, "Whenever you eat the bread and drink from this cup, remember me." Then Jesus said, "I will not be with you much longer. I have to leave. But don't worry. Do not be afraid. I will come back. You are my friends. Love each other as I love you." So why do we have this thing called communion, this church thing called communion? We have it because Jesus told us to do this with one another. Jesus told us to remember, to share this with one another, and as we share it with one another, remember him. As we remember, then we are able to be with him in a special way. So, you can do this in any with all different sorts of elements. It doesn't just need to be like the little piece of bread or the little cup of juice like you see in the sanctuary. So, this morning, I have, because I didn't have 5 loaves and 2 fishes, I have 5 fish and 2 loaves. So that's what I've got. I've got 2 crackers, and it's a very stale cracker that just broke right there. So I have 2 crackers and 5 fish. So I have that. And then I've got a little bit, just a little bit, of milk as well. So that's what I've got. So, Joe, what are some of the things that different people have? What's kind of showing up there in the chat?
We got some wise grapefruit juice.
Grapefruit juice.
Wholesome bread.
Wholesome bread. Wow. Okay. That's wow. They're some of you are much more well stocked than the Nace household right now. We're doing okay. So okay. What else do we have?
Got some orange juice, rice cakes.
Orange juice and rice cakes. That's excellent.
Pretzels.
I saw some water and crackers and water. So it's all different sorts of ways. I actually got an email from Mrs. Rash yesterday talking about what Katie, because her family was talking about communion. And Katie actually mentioned, well, when she thinks of Jesus, she thinks they're sweet. So they were going to have Milo wafers and chocolate milk. I think that's fantastic. It's wonderful. Whatever you have, no matter what you have, you are able to come and be around this table remember Jesus. It doesn't matter if this is the first time that you have had this meal or if you have been having this meal from before you can even remember. If you are able to say, God, I believe in you, then you are welcome at this table to take part, to enjoy the feast in all of its amazing ways. No matter what you have, no matter where you are, we can remember and be gathered together as the sons and daughters of the living God. Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, I thank you for this day, for this Palm Sunday, where we are able to celebrate, where we are able to remember, where we are able to be with you. Be with you as we share this cup, as we share this bread of all different varieties. I ask that you be with each and every one of these children. Be with all of their families. Allow them to be blessed by your Spirit so that they might believe, so that they might remember just how much you love them. God, we thank you for today. We thank you for this opportunity to worship and remember. It is in Jesus' name that we do pray. And all of God's children said, amen. Amen. We now have the opportunity to join together in our next hymn, which is All Glory, Laud, and Honor. Let us join together in singing All Glory, Laud, and Honor. According to Matthew, the 21st chapter, the first 11 verses. Many of you have heard me say it before that when we get to certain times of the church calendar year, there are expectations as to the biblical stories that we're going to hear. When it's Christmas, we want to hear about the angels and the shepherds. We want to gather around the manger with Mary and Joseph. Next Sunday, for Easter, we want to hear about the empty tomb. Palm Sunday, today, carries similar expectations. Well, you are going to hear what you are hoping to hear. Thankfully, the version of the story that we are able to read from this year, that's right, it's another lectionary passage, has an extra character that many of us don't picture When we draw up that mental snapshot of what it felt like for Jesus to enter in on the back of a donkey, a back of a donkey that had never been ridden, to the shouts of Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. So, who's the extra character? The donkey's mom. She doesn't get any headlines and is not part of the postcard pick that we have in our head. But in Matthew, we are reminded that she is there to guide, to comfort, to reassure, to empower. That's a reminder that we need this Holy Week. This Holy Week that is unlike any other that any of us have ever lived through. The scripture reads this way. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you humble and mounted on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks out on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them out all over the road. The crowds went ahead of him, and those that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." So ends the first reading. Our second reading comes to us from Paul's letter to the Philippians, the second chapter, verses 5 through 11. This imagery of coming alongside to guide, to comfort, to reassure, to empower, shows up in our second passage as well, as we are reminded how Jesus was willing to do everything. Of all that Jesus was willing to do for us, for humanity, as he journeyed to the cross, he came alongside. God came alongside. God is still alongside. Scripture reads this way. "Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient even to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father." So end the reading from God's holy word. May you take them into your hearts and truly live them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I don't know if I had mentioned this before, but I have never been good at learning foreign languages. I took 5 years of French between middle school, high school, and college. Do you know what I remember? Un peu. Un peu, which translates to a little. The irony is not lost on me. That's laughing too much, Joe. That's too much laughing at that. All right. Then in seminary, I had to take Hebrew and Greek, and I remembered just enough at the time to be able to pass those respective classes. I'm not proud of that. I'm just telling you that's the truth. Foreign languages and I do not get along. Over the past 3 weeks, I feel like I've been having flashbacks to those respective years, as I, like so many other parents, have been thrown into an environment that in so many ways feels like learning a foreign language. Online learning. My particular version of this theme, which is the platform that is used over at Hunterdon Central High School, Google Classroom. Between the various classrooms, the tabs with all of the different works, you know, that needs to be done in those respective classes, the emails, the calendar, which lists all of the Zoom meetings for Austin's classes, it felt like I was trying to conjugate the past participle of a reflexive verb. I don't even know if that's a thing, but that's what it felt like. As I have watched some of Austin's classmates try and navigate this world on their own, because most of Austin's classmates require some form of additional educational support, I could sense that I was not the only one who was having that feeling. Then on Friday morning, Austin was able to have a class with just one other classmate and two of their teachers, so there are four people total. Or was it? What will never show up on the attendance or in the grade book for that class was that both of those students were able to have support that was just off camera. I was there with Austin, and Michael, Austin's classmate, had his mom. 90% of the time, you didn't see myself or Michael's mom. But every now and again, just every now and again, when they needed that little bit of extra support, you would hear us, one of us, or see one of us, just for a second or two. We would come into camera, and then we would slide back out. Sound like anything else that we have heard here this morning? Yep. Donkey colt going on its maiden voyage with mom right there beside to guide, to comfort, to reassure, to empower. That is a poignant illustration, and it is way bigger than the world of donkeys. It actually models for us how God relates to each of us and how God created us to relate to God and to one another. The story of the Bible is the story of God coming alongside of humanity, begging for us to abide with Him, to abide in Him. And our invariable response of saying, "That sounds great!" And then we try and go it alone. The ultimate example of that coming alongside is the reality of Jesus, the Son of God, coming into the world, even to the point of death. To do what? To guide, to comfort, to reassure, to empower. God forgive them, for they know not what they do. Look, I know that many of us were raised with some variation of the only person that you can count on is the person that you see in the mirror. But one of the things that we are being reminded of in very real ways in this, as our world deals with COVID, is that even though we may be physically isolated, we have to be together. I'm watching as communities all across the country, and that absolutely includes our community here in Hunterdon County as well, caring for one another, caring for our doctors, our nurses, our caregivers, our neighbors, our veterans, as masks and scrub caps are being made out of bed sheets and long forgotten fabric remnants. I'm watching as teachers and parents are working with their kids so that the kids are able to feel just how cared for and loved they are, even if that care and that love has to be, for right now, through a camera on a laptop. I'm watching as friends and families are reaching out to one another, checking in with one another, finding ways to be with one another. Even as a church, as glacial as we can be in terms of trying new things, even we're trying new things so that we, as a community of faith, might be able to feel connected, so that we are able to feel with. That drive to be with one another, to come alongside one another, I very much believe is a reflection of how God is looking to be in relationship with each of us, with all of us. The God of all creation, the God who created you, is with you to guide you, to comfort you, to reassure you, to empower you. Do you believe that to be true? Do you have even the smallest kernel of faith that it is true for you? Then let him in. Let the Spirit of God seep in. As we enter into this holy week of 2020, with all of the difficult and even painful circumstances that are here, we have the opportunity to be uniquely reminded of how desperately God longs to come alongside each and every one of us. Look for that light. Let it seep in. Hold it tight so that it might be able to be shared. All right, this is not in the sermon. So I've talked with quite a few of you. I've been calling around, checking in on different folks. And several of you have talked to, who are some of our older members. I've talked about, I'm staying in and, I do need to go out and get groceries and stuff. Look, please, how can we do this in a different way so that you're able to stay safe? How can we come alongside one another so that as soon as it's safe, we're able to celebrate communion together? You're important. You're important. And I know that it's not easy. But there are ways that we can do this so that we can care for each other. How can we come alongside? Email me. Call me. Call the folks who are of a younger age and whatnot so that they're able to help us. And yes, it is stressful. And it's only going to get more stressful, but we can do this together. We can be safe, no matter what. Let God come alongside. Let God come alongside. Because we got to walk this path. And we need to walk it together. So let us pray. Holy God, in our scriptures, we have been reminded in some powerful ways the positive impact of coming alongside to comfort, to reassure, to empower, to guide. We have also seen this reality in the difficult days that are before us. Help us to lean into that truth in regard to you as well. Allow us to let you seep in, so that we might be able to feel and share your guidance, your comfort, your reassurance, your empowerment. Lord, let it be so. Amen. At this point, we now have the opportunity to share together our communion. We're going to do it in a couple of different places. I'm going to head behind the communion table here in a moment, and we'll share the liturgy together. So as I head up there, I invite you to get your communion elements so that we might be able to share them together here in just a moment. So let us prepare for communion. Brothers and sisters in Christ, this is a time for remembering, for joining together and sharing our common hope. We remember that our Lord Jesus Christ was sent by God into the world to be with us, to show us the fullness of life that even goes beyond death. By his life, death, and resurrection, Jesus established a new and eternal promise of grace that we might be accepted forever and never be forsaken. We come to have communion with this same Christ who has promised to be with us always. In the breaking of the bread, Jesus comes to us as the bread of life that strengthens us for the journey that is yet to come. In the cup of blessing, Jesus comes to us as the vine to whom we must stay attached if we are to bear fruit. We receive this bread and this wine in the hope that one day the kingdom of God will truly reign. This meal is a foretaste of that time. We are joined together as we share, and we receive this supper in gratitude for all of those who came to this table before us, and invite all of you, who acknowledge your faith in Jesus Christ to join us here at the Lord's table. I know that there are people who are worshiping here right now who have never been inside this sanctuary. This table, if you are able to say, I believe, then you are welcome at this table. This meal, this feast, is for you. So let us gather in together. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Holy Lord, we thank you for creating the whole world and calling it good. We thank you for making us in your image to live with each other in love. You have told us your purpose and commandments to Moses, called for justice through the words of the prophets. Through long generations you have been faithful to your children. Your ways are just and they are true. With people of faith from all times and all places, we lift our hearts in joyful praise, for you alone are holy.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
We thank you for Jesus who came and lived with us, being a friend to all of those who are lost and broken. We thank you that he is not dead, but is risen, risen to rule the world and is still a friend of sinners today. We trust him to overcome every power to hurt or divide us. Great God, thank you for this bread, and we ask that in its breaking, we might be joined together as the people you have called us to be. We offer this prayer in the name of the one who taught us to pray together by saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And after he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to his friends, and he said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way also, after they had eaten, he took the cup. He said, This cup is the new covenant that is found in my blood. It is the new promise that is found in my blood. Every time that you drink of it, remember me. So let us do that very thing. Let us come before the Lord and let us remember. It's the body of Christ, broken for you. Eat, remember, know that you are loved. Know that God is coming alongside even now. And now take the cup. This is the blood of Jesus Christ, allowing us to remember that his promise is eternal. No matter what you may have, drink it. Remember him. And let us pray. Holy and gracious God, as we gather into this space of worship, this space of celebration, this space of reflection, we are able to be reminded of how you have been coming alongside from the very beginning to guide, to comfort, to reassure, empower. Help us to let that presence, your presence, seep in. It is in that place that we come to you with our joys and our concerns. We pray for Claire, for Blanche, for Michael. We pray for Luke, for Chris. We pray for Melissa and for Jim. We pray for Meredith and for Austin, for Casey Jack. We pray for Carter, for Madison. We pray for their dad, John. We pray for Logan and Kate, for Lois and Haldry, for Lois and Susan, for Kim and Sue, for Joanne. We pray for our missionaries, Jeremy and Susan, as they serve in Niger. We pray for Jan and Steve. We pray for our kids down in Haiti. We pray for all of those who are connected in the military, or serving in the military, connected with our congregation, for Ben and Carlos, for Joel and Nick, for Seppi, for Kenneth and Tanner. Pray for Sean and for Joe. We also lift our prayers of condolence on the death of Adele Klein this past Tuesday. Be with her family. Be with Deb and her family. Be with Sally and Peggy. Allow them to not only know that Adele has been made well, but allow them to feel your comfort and support even now. Lord, we pray for our doctors and our nurses. We pray for all those who are helping to keep the various supply chains as connected as they possibly can be. It is getting hard. It feels like it's getting harder. Allow them to feel your presence. And as we are able to be your hands and your feet, Lord, let us be that very thing for one another. Help us to come alongside so that your presence is able to be felt in each and every one of our lives. We ask that you be with all the families who are dealing very closely with this virus. There are so many families that are grieving today. Lord, be with them. We also pause so that we might be able to offer up all the joys and concerns that we carry with us this day. Lord, hear our prayers in the quiet of this place. You are with us. God, you are with us. Let us let you seep in so that we might be able to feel your guidance, your comfort, so that we might be able to feel your reassurance and your empowerment today. God, thank you. All these things we do pray in Jesus' name. And all of God's children said, amen. Thank you. this week that is holy. We are able to recognize through the story of our Savior the reality that His grace is enough. Even when hardships arrive, even when betrayals and disappointments, when grief and sadness are there, His grace is enough. Allow that reality to be a part of your life right now. Let that flow into your life. Let God seep in. Let Him come alongside to guide, to support, to empower. You are loved. Let us care for one another as God has first loved us. Now, with the power of God the Father, love of God the Son, communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.